her surrounding pain care, and a terrifying environment for pain patients. The intended harms of opioid reform are devastating, but the unintended consequences are catastrophic. We've plagued every aspect of pain care with fear, misinformation, and abandon until every facet had been deteriorated. And today, we have patients fighting to live, doctors afraid to prescribe, and pharmacists policing orders of physicians. And what is the common denominator? Fear. To begin, I ask you to understand that opioids can save lives, and they save mine every day. I have stiff person syndrome, a disease that causes severe and unrelenting spasms, and opioids were not my first line of defense. I tried a slew of movement disorder drugs, experimental procedures, chemotherapy, IVIG, plasmapheresis, and a range of different stem cell sources. And while this climate would have most wishing I found a more acceptable source of disease management, as a patient, I can tell you that opioids were the miracle that restored my functionality and therefore my life. And it's not about me, it's about the thousands of patients just like me. We've heard of the dangers of over-treatment of pain, and why have we not considered the dangers of under-treatment of pain? Guidelines were written, legislation was passed, and yet no one was taking care to understand the devastation that was unraveling as a result. We have physicians that are terrified to care for their practice. We have doctors who are forced to choose between their livelihood and their patients. And when faced with that choice, most simply stop prescribing. We have pharmacists who have been tasked from policing prescription fills without any knowledge of the patient's history or disease process. And when faced with that responsibility, many simply refuse the fill. We have created countless obstacles to the patient where anyone can prevent their access to opioid medication, and yet no one can seem to safely prescribe it to them. And so when we discuss the practices for pain care, we need to remember that we are treating pain. Pain is the affliction and opioids are the available remedy, but we have let fear and stigma dictate the care for human beings. We have created a world in which patients are living in 30-day intervals of terror, and yet we consider ourselves to be a nation that prides itself on empathy and exemplary health care. And lastly, I ask you to realize that those suffering from chronic pain are so much more than patients. Their mothers and fathers, their sisters and brothers, they're someone's child and someone's neighbor. And I ask you if pain patients deserve the right to an identity. Leave it to the last card. Because their very lives depend on access to a medication that they've allowed to become unattainable.